Hey guys, it's Bianca. I hope you guys can see me and hear me. I am actually doing a little bit of running around today, as always. I just came from a meeting for another teaching position, and the lady that I interviewed with, we hit it off very, very well, from both of our standpoints, from what I could feel, we just hit it off on a professional level, you know, like her company is what I'm looking for, as well as I seem to be what she's looking for her company as well. Try and get over. Thank you, sir. So her company is what I'm looking for, and I seem to be what her company is looking for. She's going to let me talk to somebody else a little bit, like, higher in the company, and just kind of, you know, I guess, like, as an added bonus, but she, like, verbatim told me, like, I would love to have you on, like, based on our conversation today and all this good stuff. So I'm really, really excited to hear back from her. She told me to expect a call in a couple of days from the higher-ups, so hopefully that goes over well. And I'm kind of liking that position as well, because I get to do dance, but I also get to do cheer and sports a little bit too, because it's kind of like it's more like it's dance, cheer, and sports classes for like small children, on top of the dance that I've been doing for the other company. Sorry about that. My phone said that I was talking too much and overheated. This is actually the first time that, like, being down in Florida is the only time that I remember of my phone, like, just overheating. And it happens, like, almost every day. Like, anytime I'm driving with my phone up there, it overheats. So sometimes I just put it in my lap. Because I'm usually listening to music, so I normally don't like to have the GPS, like, talking to me, because it kind of cuts into the music. But if it overheats, I put it in the seat next to me, in the passenger seat, and I just do what I gotta do, and, you know, put the, you know, let the GPS talk to me. I usually turn the volume off when I'm driving, if I'm listening to music, but it's been overheating lately. But luckily, I already know where I'm going here, so I don't have to, I'm not really using the GPS because I've been here so many times. As long as I remember which exit I gotta get off, everything else is like, you know, perfect, whatever. So, but yeah, that's pretty much it. I was just kind of talking about, like, collaboration and how important it is in the entertainment industry. And not necessarily collaboration for your own gain. Like, oh, let me collaborate with you because you have clout. Like, you know, not saying, like, don't collaborate with people who have clout, or don't collaborate with people who have connections, but don't only collaborate with people. Or don't treat people like their position, if that makes sense. And I was actually having a meeting yesterday, and we were talking about that. Like, don't treat people like their position. Treat them like humans. And even when you make it big, like, be grateful. Don't be one of those people that's like, I'm the... Like, you know, nothing wrong with confidence, but when it's cocky, it's like, no. Even if you are, like, very, very talented, if you're cocky, it's like, no. And I've been taught by there's different people, like, no, you gotta walk in the room like this and let them know, and things like that. And there's a, you know, it's different walking in the room like, hi, how are, like, you know, looking them in the eye and very, like, confident with your movements and confident, you know, with what you're saying and things like that. There's a big difference between being like, you know what, don't even, you know, you already know I'm the best. You know, like, there's a big difference. You can show that you believe in yourself without being shady towards everybody else, or, you know, things like that. And, you know, not everybody does that. Not everybody understands that. And so I'm kind of like, I was kind of explaining too that, you know, I didn't follow it. And, you know, but yeah, I didn't follow the whole, like, oh, trying to, like, pretend like I'm the best thing since sliced bread, you know, to convince somebody that I'm confident, you know, or being super extra if that's not who I am. You know, there's some people who, you know, that's who they are, and they're, like, super, super, like, outgoing and like, bubbly and all of that, and that's, you know, that's cool because that's who they are, and that's gonna come off natural. But to try and, like, make that up, now, don't get me wrong, I have my moments where I'm, like, cracking jokes, and I'm, you know, like, I have my moments, I have my, you know, fun side or whatever, but I'm not going to, like, pretend to be somebody else or put on, you know, like, unless I'm, like, in an acting thing and I'm, like, trying to let them know, like, oh, yeah, I can play this part, but, like, I'm not gonna pretend to be whatever, you know. I might be a little bit more, like, forthgoing, where I might be in a mood where I just kind of want to lay back, but I know in a professional setting you can't always do that, so that's different. But to just be like, oh yeah, hi, my name's Bianca, I'm the best thing since sliced bread, and you know you need to hire me, girl. Like, no. But, you know, a lot of people, not only do a lot of people think that that's how it's done, but a lot of people buy it, and I'm like, nah, like, what? I wouldn't want to work with somebody who does that, because you know that they're not going to mesh well with other people. But, you know, to each their own. It works for some people. But I don't just do what works because it works. It has to work and be the right thing. That's how I get down. I'm gonna let you guys go because I'm almost there. But that, I just really, really think that's important in anything, in entertainment, in business, and all of that. Like, it's really, really, really important to find like-minded people that, you know, let you be you, and that, like, let you be you and value you for you, and you value them for them, and you guys help each other. Because when you help your, like, I loved what the young lady was saying yesterday, and I'm saying young lady, and I'm the youngest person in all of these meetings, but I call, they're young, but probably like a couple years older than me, but yeah, young. So it's like, you want to be in an environment where there's give and take, give and take, give and take, and there's no, you know, it's not just one way, or it's not just, okay, maybe there might be give and take, but every favor that's done for you is, like, kind of held over your head. But then when you do a favor, it's either not seen as anything, like, oh, you could have done that better, or oh, you don't really do anything, or, you know, like, not really appreciative. Or they just figure, like, oh, you should be doing, like, you know, like, you owe me or whatever. And that's not a good thing, because if they really believe that, then they're just gonna feel like a martyr, like, you know, oh man, I do all this for this person or whatever, and it's just not good. And then on top of that, you're not gonna feel too hot. And a lot of times, you know, it's just not healthy. So I think finding people, like, we were talking about, like, all of this, like, just, like, the industry. And she was just talking about, like, you know, with women, how, because she writes, she produces, she acts, all of that. And, you know, I don't really want to go too much into it, but she was just talking about, like, you know, making better opportunities for women to where they're only doing what they're comfortable doing and all of that. And I was like, yes. And then that's when we start talking about the whole collaboration. And it's like, you know, that happens, you know, with a lot. You know, that happens among people who, you know, like she was saying, and I agree, like, people think that, you know, if they give you a job or if they do this or if they do that or whatever, like, you owe them or you have to do whatever they tell you to do. And if you say, I'm not comfortable, or, you know, whatever. Now, there's a difference between being like, I'm not comfortable. Like, because she was like, you know, she had like a filtering system. Like, if it doesn't interfere with my morals, if it doesn't hurt me, like, physically, mentally, you know, emotionally, anything like that, and if I can do it, then okay, you know, I'll do it. Even if it's hard, even if I'm like, oh, I don't know if I can do that, I might not be, you know, fit enough, or like, for me, I might not be loud enough, whatever, but, you know, or it might be hard work or whatever, like, that's different. Like, don't, you know, don't be a diva or a divo, like, oh, I don't want to do that, that's too much. But if it's something that really, you know, it's, you know, you're just not comfortable doing it, and somebody's like, you owe me, I made you, or whatever, like, nah, that's not cute. Or, oh, you wouldn't have this if it wasn't for me, that's not cute. So that's what I mean by all that extra stuff that often happens in the industry. And it's sad that it happens, but honestly, there's a lot of amazing people in the industry too. And a lot of those things that happen is probably because it happened to them and, you know, whatever. Or, you know, they're hurt about something, like, you know, I don't want to be like cliche, but that's usually what it is. Or they're taught that's the way. Like, if I do something for you, I own you. And that's not the way. You know, maybe they feel like they don't want to be taken advantage of. Like, if I do something for you, I want a return. But it's like, you're gonna get your return. You're going to. Like, I've had so many, like, when people do stuff for me, they might not always know it, but I had so many plans for, like, the people who've done stuff for me. Like, oh, bet. Oh, you did this for me? Okay. Like, I might be, you know, trying to make it now, but, yo, when I get, like, where I'm going, or as I'm getting there and I have enough, you know, I got you. And not even just money, but, like, you know, oh, I'm gonna let them know, like, you know, this person was amazing, this person is talented as well. Like, you know, that's how it is. And then even during that, like, if I get if I get any opportunities, I'm like, oh, by the way, have you heard of so-and-so? Have you heard of so-and-so? Have you heard, like, every little thing I get. But it's like, you know, some people, you know, there's other intentions for what they do. And that's not enough for them. Because some people, they want you to do well, but not better than them. And I'm not here saying that I'm doing better than anybody, but people can think that you're doing better than them, even if you're not. You might not be, but people can think that. I don't go around thinking that or saying that or anything like that, but, you know, things happen. And yeah, and like I said, I'm not really talking about anybody in general, just kind of going over what we were talking about in the conversation, because we talked for a while. I've been loving these meetings lately, because we've been talking for a while and getting into a lot of well-needed discussions. But yeah, I'm gonna let you guys go. I'm trying to figure out how to wear my hair. But I'm going to let you guys go. Because it's almost... It probably is time for... what you call them. And I'm going to go change. And I might talk to you guys later. I don't know. But if not, I hope you guys have... I hope you guys have a great day. And I will see you guys later. Bye. Hey guys. So I think I said in a video before... that I wanted to start recording some of the videos that, or recording videos of some of the dances that I've been making up. And this is a dance that I recently taught at a trial class. I definitely maybe want to shoot it somewhere. Like maybe get the lighting situated a little bit more for it, or shoot it at a location. But I just want to start getting them on video, just so that they're there. If anyone asks, like, oh, can I see some of your choreo? They're there. And yeah, just so that I have somewhat of a portfolio of what I've been making up, so that it's not all up here. Because I have a great memory, but I don't want to use all that memory trying to remember, you know, all the creative things I have in my head, you know. I'll remember it once I see it and once I hear the song, but I just want to kind of like free up my headspace and maybe take away some of the anxiety I have, because I get very like, okay, I have all these ideas, but like, I need to do them, even if it's just in my living room, even if, you know, like, even if it's just, like, by myself, like, I need to express these ideas that I have. So, I'm gonna do a video. Again, guys, do not judge me if the lighting is not perfect or whatever. Yeah, I just wanna kinda, like, get it all out there. And I may put it up, I may not. So, if you see this, then I probably put it up. But yeah, with that being said, stay tuned.